Thank you. Hold on there. This is a family matter. The lady will attend to you shortly.
I'm going to ask you again, Jessica. Are you entirely bereft of compassion? Will you not mourn your own brother's death?
Not this again! Of course I'm sad. I can't believe I even have to say it. But all you can think of is tradition and family obligations. I'm talking about avenging his murder!
Avenging? You will stop this foolishness this instant. You are a young lady, not a warrior. Do you really think Alistair would have wanted this? You will mourn your brother's death like a proper lady. It's our family's way.
Our family's way? Who cares about our family's way? I don't expect you to believe me, but Alistair spoke to me. He told me to follow my heart. That's why my mind is made up. I don't care about the consequences. I'm going to make Alistair's murderer pay.
Very well. It's obvious there's no talking to you. Do as you wish. But, as far as I'm concerned, I no longer have a daughter. I want you out of this house at once!
Fine! I was planning on leaving until you came to your senses anyway! Bangers! Mash! Let me through! I'm getting my things! I'm sorry for not telling you the truth before. Forgive me.
Are you really leaving, Jessica?
Yeah, I am. And I want you two to watch over the village while I'm gone. Alistair told me this would happen. He said you two would protect the town and grow up to be famous warriors. Come on, chin up. Your mission guarding my room is over. I want you to patrol outside from now on.
Yes, sir!
Well, I'm leaving. Thanks for being such a great mum. Have a nice life!
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Don't have time to argue. I want you to put out to sea now.
My apologies, Miss Jessica, but the waters are simply too dangerous at the moment.
Haven't you been listening? I told you I'd take care of that.
Please forgive me, Lady Jessica. There'd be hell to pay from the Albert family if we put you in danger.
Is there anyone around here with half a brain? Ah, speak of the devil. You're the travelers from the tower. Didn't I tell you to wait for me in Alexandria? I wanted to properly apologize to you. Well, whatever. I'm glad you're here now. Actually, I have a favor to ask. Would you mind coming over here for a minute? So, you're saying you won't let me fight the sea monster?
Well, yes, but... I mean...
Fine, fine. Not to worry. I've asked these sturdy men to take care of it for me. Okay?
Oh, well. Actually, we've been looking for someone to take on that very job ourselves.
Well, there you have it. Everyone's happy. Can I count on you guys? I knew I could count on you. I still can't get what we saw in the tower out of my mind. Who is this Dhoulmagus? And what does he want? And why did he murder my brother? I'll track him to the ends of the earth. But first, we've got to make the waters safe for ships to sail. The sea monster that's standing in our way is supposed to be pretty strong. You'd better be prepared. I'll be waiting here. Come back as soon as you're ready.
Thank you.
ready to set sail. What? You still aren't ready? So why are you hanging around here? Hurry up and do whatever it is you have to do. I'll be waiting here. Come back as soon as you're ready. Are you ready to set sail? Okay, then. Quartermaster, prepare the ship!
Aye, aye, sir! Prepare to set sail! Weigh anchor!
No, I hate your tootickles! These nasty humans and their ships! Always sailing over poor Calamari's head!
Yeah, Tenta, yeah. You humans don't have no manners!
That's right, Tickles! They don't have none at all, they don't! No!
That's why Calamari's gonna stand up for all the poor creatures of the sea! Starting by eating these here humans!
Yeah, Tickles, yeah! He'll eat him! Eat him right up!
Thank you.
They were stronger than we thought.
We give up! We give up!
Sure, it wasn't our fault, though. It was his! That's right, it was. That jester, he came walking on top of the water to us. Just walked over us. He did! Pretty cheeky of a human to pull that little trick off, we thought.
So we talked to him, we did.
But when he talked,
our head got all cloudy-like, and we started attacking ships.
We did. It wasn't us. It was that jester. It was.
Is this by way of an apology, like?
No.
We found it in the ocean. We did.
Go on, take it, mate.
It's the least we can do.
Well, that is all from us. We are leaving now. We are. Have a pleasant trip. So long.
Not bad, guys. You're a lot stronger than you look. You know, we've never properly introduced ourselves. I'm Jessica. Jessica Albert. And who might you be?
I'm Yangus, and this here's the Gov.
Yangus and the Gov, is it? Right. Thanks again for your help with the sea monster. Now, let's find Dhoulmagus. I'm sure you need to get ready first, so let's head back to Port Prospect. I'll tell the captain to weigh anchor. Oh, I almost forgot. I called you two thieves back at the tower, and I never formally apologized. So, forgive me. Anyway, I'll talk to the captain.
All hands on deck! Weigh anchor and prepare to come about! We're heading back to Port Prospect!
We took care of the sea monster, so I got them to agree to wait for us. I figured you'd like to rest and buy provisions before we set sail again. I'll be waiting for you here. Don't take too long now. We've got work to do. Actually, before we go, I have a favor to ask. You're after Dhoulmagus just like I am, right? We're fighting for the same reasons. So I was thinking, why don't we do this together? I haven't been studying magic for long, but I still have a lot to offer. What do you say? I've got a great feeling about this. Thanks, guys. Well, now that that's taken care of, let's go.
Just where do you think you're going without me and my beautiful princess?
All hands on deck! Weigh anchor! Prepare to set sail for Pereguin Quay!
Ah, there you are. So what are you two up to?
Up to? Me and the Gov was just talking, that's all.
Gov, huh? I've been meaning to ask you about that. You know, he doesn't exactly look like your governor. If anything, it looks the other way around. What's the story?
Well, I'm glad you asked. The story of how me and the Gov fell in together is an epic tale, full of laughter, frills and tears.
It is it? Well, why don't you just give me the highlights?
All right, I will. It all started on a fine summer's day. The sound of insects was deafening. I just decided to make a clean break of it. I was well act off with the old bandithood. So I decided to leave the town that I lived in my whole life and start a fresh life. I ain't exactly a looker, as you can see. Perhaps that's why people treated me funny everywhere I went, like I was a thief or something. I didn't have no place to go, and not a penny to me name neither. So I ended up going back to the old game. And that's when I run into the Gov here. Hold it right there. Who gave you permission to use my bridge then, eh?
Permission? Permission? Your bridge lies within my kingdom, you oaf.
What are you on about? A creepy old codger like you? A king? Don't make me laugh.
I see your mouth is as vulgar as your face. Yes, I'm the king. And who exactly you think you are?
Me? Hearing my name is enough to make anyone wet their knickers. That's right! You're talking to none other than Yangus, the legendary bandit himself.
Yangus?
The one and only. Time to cough up. You have to pay if you want to cross my bridge.
The one and only Yangus? What a shame there aren't more of you. Now kindly remove your one and only self from my bridge and clear off.
Don't push your luck, you green-faced freak. I would have let you go if you'd have kept your gob shut and paid up. But you want to do this the hard way, eh?
Yes.
Now, my boy, now's our chance to cross.
Just my blade luck.
Now that's what I call just desserts. As the saying goes, crime doesn't pay. Let us carry on then, my boy. There, there, my precious Medea. Did the bad man scare you? What are you doing? But he attacked us. Why the devil are you helping him? Just leave him. It's poetic justice. Nay, divine justice.
Thank you, Governor. I thought I was done for.
What is the world coming to? Yangus, was it? You can show your gratitude by getting out of our sight.
You're having a laugh.
What? Still here? If you won't do us the favor of leaving, I'll be happy to provide some encouragement.
Mister? No, Governor. I really owe you. You saved my life and everything. You're the bee's knees, Gov.
Gov? What is this nonsense? Are you a complete imbecile? This boy is my retainer. If you're in anyone's service, it's mine.
Put a sock in it. I ain't talking to you. He's the one who saved me.
Put a sock in it! Who do you think you're speaking to, you good-for-nothing scoundrel?
So that's how you met. What happened to all the laughter, thrills and tears?
Well, I'm not finished yet. This is the best bit. I haven't told you about how the Gov helped me go straight.
Whatever. You can tell me all about it later. Right now, I need some fresh air.
I should have known a bird wouldn't get a story like ours, Gov. Still, no skin off my nose.
Thank you.
I did it! I finally did it! Ah, there you are! Perfect timing! I've got something to show you! Ta-da! Looks like a normal pot, doesn't it? But it's actually a legendary alchemy pot. I can see that doesn't mean much to you. Allow me to explain. The alchemy pot is an invaluable tool for making different kinds of items. It lets you mix different ingredients to create hard-to-find items, armor, and weapons. After my kingdom was cursed, I thought it might come in handy and managed to spirit it out of the castle. But that's not all. I spent night after night trying to get it working again. No, you can thank me later. Right. Well, it's in my carriage, so why don't you give it a try? It's surprisingly easy to use.
Captain, land ho!
Belay the rigging and prepare to make port.
Aye, aye, sir.
Helmsman! Bring us alongside Pereguin Quay!
It looks like we've arrived. I'll meet you outside town with Medea and the carriage. It wouldn't do to stir up the natives again with my extraordinary appearance.
Thank you. Thank you.